What I was thinking about when I heard that the song was about being a proud Korean, I thought it would take aspects of the culture, really. Y'all seen Idol, like the music video type of stuff, like, you know, it was showing off their culture and their traditional wear. I'm pretty sure y'all could have, like, done that, you know, like. So I just want you guys to keep in mind that this video is a rant, so this means I was literally just saying what was on my mind at the time. I didn't write up a whole like paper and have a whole script ready. What was y'all thoughts on the whole video? How were y'all feeling about it?
So I was gonna do this video, but someone even requested me to do a video on this, so I was like, yes, yeah, say less, say less. I know who he is. When I was first getting into K-pop, if you want to see how I got into K-pop, I watched this whole like problematic video about K-pop idols, and he was in a few of them. So I was like, oh, okay.
I'ma keep it a buck with y'all. My whole facial expression just showed confusion through the whole reaction part. But if you want to hear me rant, just skip to the time that's right below right there. I'ma save the commentary to the end, but I think they took down the original video because it's not popping up.
The video was not showing what the lyrics was showing, in my opinion. Like, they could have showed off like their own culture, in my opinion. I was not messing with the video, you know. I got a Glock. Okay, this is my turn. Oh, okay.
As y'all seen, there was a lot of cultural appropriation. Are we surprised? No, we're not. I am not surprised. I expected it, really. All I gotta say is that if y'all don't understand, it's just a hairstyle. If it was just a hairstyle, we wouldn't be here today, would we? We wouldn't be having this conversation. This thing wouldn't even exist if it was, oh, it's just a hairstyle. The reason why it's more than just a hairstyle, if you have like a type of, I have like 4C hair, right? I have coily hair. People cannot wear that without it being called like ghetto or unattractive or like unkept. And I'm just like, dang, I really can't like just wear my own hair out. I wear my hair out, but you know, I enjoy the wig so it can like grow and stuff, for protective styles. And even with wigs, that's a whole nother can for another. So it's just like when people take it on themselves and do it in like, oh, it's a cool, trendy way. You see why people have a problem, and people hype them up too. But when someone with the actual hair has it, it's like, oh, that's kind of, are you gonna like do it? I'm gonna fix it. And sometimes it don't even be other people. Sometimes it be like the black community too. Like, what you mean? Now, me personally, I'm gonna be real with y'all. We can't control everybody and what they do to their hair, you know? But like, why when I do it, it's like, you know? Had to go and had a perm like to that head, like it took some time. I don't think he has naturally 4C hair. He didn't come out and say it. So somebody had to do that little curl. Like, gosh. And then the braid, like, you know what, go ahead and do it. But if your hair fall out, it's not meant for your hair. But if your hair falls out, hey, don't say that we didn't warn you. At this point, if I do it, leave me the fuck alone. The whole thing about it is the video is about being a proud Korean or being proud to be Korean. You couldn't have done anything that like symbolized like traditional like Korea or Korean, if that makes sense. Like, what I was thinking about when I heard that the song was about being a proud Korean, I thought it would take aspects of the culture, really. Idol, like the music video type of stuff, like, you know, it was showing off their culture and their traditional wear. So I was like, ooh, that was cool. And it was like, I got to see like another like culture, and I'm like, oh, that's sweet, that's amazing.
y'all, I'm pretty sure y'all could have like done that, you know, like I had black people in there to the point they could have done like the hairstyles and stuff. It's the whole thing about profiting off of black culture really for me. I'm just like, I'm not surprised, because it's like I can't go anywhere without someone actually like profiting off of black culture. So at this point it's just like, okay, I guess we are the blueprint, because like, y'all, come on. It's disappointing, really. I wanted to make like a video. I had like, this was a video I wanted to do a long time ago where I go in depth about talking about colorism and a cultural appropriation and the whole N-word. I had a whole like video, like this was a while ago. And the whole, like I said before, the whole reason why I accidentally got into K-pop was because I wanted to educate myself on colorism in the black community, if that makes sense. Because I'm like, I know we're not the only people with the melanated skin. So how is it like over there in Asia? Because, you know, I know in, I remember watching this video in India. It's like, it's no better. When I went towards Southeast Asia, it definitely wasn't any better. And I'm just like, dang, that's considered black to y'all. I must be charcoal then. Must be, y'all. So it was really interesting to see that, and I think I want to go more into like colorism and colorism in K-pop, and then colorism and just all in general. Maybe make a video on that, but I have to like do my research. I don't want to be like rambling and stuff. And same thing with the N-word and stuff like that, because y'all know everybody's name. I'm like to say that word, but the J-Park thing, y'all. I'm sorry. I'm black before I'm anything. Apology too. I don't know if I, cause like I think he took down a video. I can't find it. The apology was just like some, black hip-hop originated from Latinos and black people. I know this part. I think he brings in like other people that use their culture, and I'm like, yo, that don't make it right. Like, if you need to call those people out, because, you know, that's the kettle calling a teapot. Like, but that what they did, like Nicki Minaj in that Chung Lee video, no, I was, because when I was watching, I'm like, ain't that a bit of a cultural appropriation? Like, I don't think that's okay. When people appropriate other people's culture, they need to be called out. You can't let that slide. I don't care how big that is. If you feel like your culture is getting disrespected or not being used in the proper way, you need to say something. You need to say something. I'm sorry. So right here, I'm going to say something, because I don't, it's not sitting right with me. And it's not like you have like, how many label, he don't have that many like black artists under his label, even at that. I don't think you're for, like, you know, for black artists, the foundation of hip-hop, like that, more of a way as to profit off of it. Y'all, please leave y'all like comments, like y'all's like stuff down below in the comment section if you have anything to talk about, because honestly I want to see this, because it's not sitting right with me. How is a song about being a proud Korean but you're over here appropriating black culture? I don't get it. I'm not surprised though, and I'm not gonna say everybody in the K-pop industry like does this, or everybody in the music industry at that does this, but there's a good portion, a great portion that does it. And I'm just like, I'm not surprised at this point. When I got into K-pop, I was not surprised. I was like, oh, okay, same thing, different font, really, same thing, different language, really. I was like, okay, okay. Jay Park need a timeout for real though. Man is nearly 40, I believe. Come on now, you can't excuse, he doesn't know. Yo, I know in my other video I was talking about even thinking that you know better is expecting too much, but to be in like hip-hop, you at least have to educate yourself on that, like especially in music. Yeah, and see, that's where the thing comes in. When is it a cultural appreciation? When is it a cultural appreciation or cultural appropriation? Like, if you know what is going on, if you know the culture, if you did the research, if you understand it, how do you show that to some? I don't know, y'all. But I mean, you should have expected that, like when you do stuff like that, people gonna talk. But me, honestly, I feel like you can't quite tell what a person can. You can't like really say, hey, you can't do this to your hair. They're gonna be like, oh, why not? It's just the matter of when we do it, when we like, it's our, like some people in my community, they naturally have that hair, and when they wear that out, it's deemed as, oh no, like, huh? But when somebody else do it, that's fine. When we get braids so we can protect our hair, because it is a lot to keep it maintained, it's kind of ghetto with the braid, like, huh? But when someone else do it, it's okay. I don't get it, and I don't like it. That's my main problem with it. What was y'all thoughts on the video? Because hell, so the, you know, anyways, what was y'all thoughts on the video?
If you enjoyed this video, maybe give it a big thumbs up. And, you know, why not subscribe? You know, I am small. Thanks for 500 plus subscribers. I plan on doing a giveaway at 1,000, like a $50 gift card. So, yeah. Yeah, another part of my RC Entertainment thing should be up next week around Monday again. And, yeah, just thanks for watching. And if you enjoyed, yeah, y'all know what's up. So, yeah.